Hi friends, and welcome back to my channel and today's video. So the Swedish word of the day is clean, which is the Swedish städa. Städa. I just realized that maybe the word should be cleaning up, because it's like I need to clean up my house. So it's not like it's something is clean. So just so you get that little reference, because after this video, I need to go ahead and städa my apartment. Anyway, today I'm going to talk about some products that I was planning on purchasing, but I never did. So there's a lot of products coming out all of the time, and there's a lot of products that really piques my interest and that I am going to purchase because I'm like so excited about them. And for one reason or another, I never ended up purchasing them, but my intention was to 100% go ahead and purchase them. But for, as I said, one reason or another, maybe it's because I don't live in Europe or whatever, that I just didn't get my hands on them. So that is what I'm going to talk about today. And the first thing is Too Faced Tutti Frutti collection. Now, if you live in Denmark or Sweden, or not Norway, because Norway, for some reason, doesn't even have Sephora, but Too Faced is only sold at Sephora in Sweden. And as I'm filming this video, Sephora has come out and said that we are going to get the Too Faced Tutti Frutti collection to Sweden really soon, or to Sephora Scandinavia soon. That was 2 weeks ago, still hasn't happened, but eventually we will get it. But I will say that as of this point, I'm like so annoyed that I'm not that into purchasing it. Maybe I'll go ahead and purchase like a blush or something, but for now I have not. And I don't like, if that collection had come to Sweden the minute it came to the US, I would have purchased way more products than I have in my collection at the moment, because I haven't been able to purchase it at Sephora, and then I haven't been able to purchase it on some of the UK websites like Cult Beauty or other websites like that. So that is something that is like so annoying, because it's so annoying when you really want to purchase something but you can't, just because of a brand is being negligent to your country and to a lot of countries. Too Faced, you need to up your game right now. So if you've been on my channel for quite some time, you know that I used to obsess about this palette. I went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Should I get it? Should I not? I really wanted it, but the one reason why I never ended up purchasing it is because of the fact that I thought that I wouldn't get that much use out of it. And today I'm really happy that I don't own it. And I have hair on my lip. By the way, filmed this look, used Rood Cosmetics product, so if that video is up, link it up here. If it's not, it's coming. But the palette that I really wanted to purchase was the Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Glam palette, or Soft Glam, as a lot of people says. But when it comes to brown shadows, I love my browns to be on the warmer side. They can be neutral as well, I don't mind that. But on the warmer side is usually my preference. So of course that palette should have piqued my interest, but the one reason that I didn't purchase it is because of the fact that the shimmers did not speak to me. When I am using browns, neutrals, or even purples, because I've said this before, but purples are kind of my browns, I love for an everyday to use something light on the lid. So for instance, something with a light champagne color, or something with like a light pinky color, or a light purple, even light blues or light green, something like that. That is my goal. Like, that is something that I love. I don't love the bronzier shade. So to me, I just never ended up purchasing it. And now I'm actually kind of happy that I didn't purchase it, because I know that I would not have used that palette as it deserved. Now, when it comes to my eyeshadow palettes, I don't use most of my eyeshadow palettes as they deserve, but they still get used. Oh my god, I used to obsess about this brand and I was so close to purchasing it. So 2017, my goal, or my main top brand going into 2018, was Tarte. I was so into trying a lot of Tarte products. I really wanted to try their blushes, their concealer, their foundations, their eyeshadows, their cheek palettes, like everything. I just wanted to try Tarte. But I never ended up doing it. I think the main reason why I didn't do it is because, okay, I'm gonna get to the product first, but the Shape Tape Concealer was of course something that I really wanted to try because a lot of people were just talking about it. It didn't matter on which YouTube channel you went to, everyone was using it, everyone was telling you how good it was. If you hadn't tried it, then you were kind of like this weirdo. Maybe they didn't say it, but I for sure felt like a weirdo for not trying it out. So that was kind of my top priority, but then kind of the flop came with Tarte when they released their Shape Tape foundation, and I wasn't that into purchasing from the brand at that point. And then I was really happy because I was planning on purchasing this big eyeshadow palette from them, and I just know that I would not have used that. I know that that would end up in my disappointments, or like a video with products I never use, or just something like that. So I felt like I didn't want to go to Tarte and only purchase a concealer. I wanted to purchase a concealer and something else. I have a little banana fly that keeps flying here and it really bothers me. It's kind of just teasing me, flying in front of the camera like, ha ha, you can't get me, na 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 na. So if you do live in Europe, you kind of know how it is, like for instance, to order from ColourPop. You don't want to go to ColourPop and just order a lipstick, because that is such a waste of money, because you have to pay shipping and customs just for a lipstick. You don't want to do that. And that is the same way I felt with Tarte. I don't want to pay customs and shipping only for a concealer. And I just couldn't decide on which my other product should be, so I never ended up purchasing it. And now it's Tarte is on its way to Sweden at Sephora, so who knows, when this video goes up, maybe I have purchased the concealer. So I know that you guys are really weak for eyeshadow palettes, and so am I, which you guys know. We love to talk about eyeshadow palettes on this channel, but there was this one palette that everyone kept raving about, and Stephanie Nicole, I remember, talked really, really highly about this brand and this palette, and that was, of course, the Colored Rain Queen of Hearts palette. I kind of wanted to say the Vivid Pigments palette, but no. That palette was so popular and I wanted it so bad. But it was limited edition and it kind of went away. And I was so sad because I don't remember if it was on Beauty Bay or if I went to Color Rain's website, but one reason or another, I went to someone's website and I was going to purchase it, but then it was sold out and I was like, damn you all, I'm gonna freaking kill someone. Like, I was so annoyed. But then it wasn't limited edition anymore. And then I started looking at the palette more and more and more. Yes, it's a beautiful palette, but to me, it wasn't something really unique. I love the berry shades, the orange kind of destroyed that palette a little bit for me. I don't know what it was, but it was something that, you know, when you kind of look at it and then you look at it and you look at it and you really try to analyze it. I have even to, like, the last week, I went to Beauty Bay just to check on that palette, and I was like, maybe I should purchase it because it was on sale. But then I didn't, and I think that that is a palette that I will always kind of love from afar, but never really get into my collection. So maybe around 2 years ago, I purchased a highlight from Becca. I don't have it anymore, but I purchased the Shadow Pearl, which is a white highlight. It was really, really powdery, but I remember loving it. I actually went back to some of my old videos. I think that they were in Swedish. I don't really remember, but I have them on, I have them saved on my computer, and I saw when I had it on, I applied highlight, but I never blended it into my skin. So this was kind of just like a stripe of white highlight. It looked horrible on me. I'm telling you, it looked so bad, but I still, for some reason, love the formula. And I will say that I don't love the formula of that Becca highlight. The Pearl one, in my opinion, is too powdery and doesn't really represent Becca's highlights. But then I purchased the Shadow Opal, or the highlight Opal. Loved it. I thought that it was great. That was during the time when I always self-tan. I'm too lazy for that, so that's why I never really do it. I don't know. I feel like it's messy, it gets on your clothes. I don't really know. It's just not really something for me. But I did have a period when I loved it, and That's when I kind of used the living crap out of that highlight. But when I stopped self-tanning, I really wanted to purchase the Shadow Moonstone. And I've been going back and forth with that, but the thing is that that one was, it's so expensive. And that's kind of what's holding me back. I don't know what it is, but I've said this before as well, that I have such a hard time pulling the trigger when it comes to purchasing from Sephora. If Becca was available at any other website in Sweden, I would probably already own it. But since it's only available at Sephora, I have never gone around to purchase it. And that is the main reason why I don't have it. Let me talk about one last product, and we're gonna end it with a bang. We're gonna end it with an indie brand and an eyeshadow palette. So there was this one eyeshadow palette that everyone was raving about. It wasn't from an indie brand. This is from an indie brand that I have never tried, but it was located in the UK, so really accessible to me. Didn't have to pay customs and everything like that. And that was the September Rose Slush palette. I have talked about this before, guys, but that palette to me is so unique, it's so beautiful, and I went to the website multiple times putting it in my car but never pulling the trigger. And the main reason for that is because I had already purchased so many colorful palettes, and I had purchased so many rainbow palettes, and I was just overwhelmed with the amount of palettes coming in, and I was just like grabbing everything. It felt like that. And now when I know that they are doing a Slush 2 palette, like a new version of that palette, I don't really feel like getting the first one. Now I kind of want to wait, save my money, and maybe purchasing the second one if it looks good. I haven't even seen it when filming this, so I don't really know, but yeah, I don't know, that palette was just gorgeous to me. But then I also have heard from you guys that you have said, some of you guys says that the palette is great, it's great quality, everything like that. But then I've heard from a lot of other people like, okay, the mattes aren't the best, but some people love the mattes, and then some people hate the shimmers, and some people love the shimmers. So I don't know if it's just like personal preference, or if there's been something weird with the palettes in production, I don't know. But I never ever pulled the trigger on it, but I still, that is also a palette that I'm really loving from afar, and maybe that is one product that I might actually end up purchasing if I'm gonna purchase the Slush 2 palettes. Maybe I'm purchasing both at the same time, I don't really know. Anyway, that was all of the products that I had to talk about today. I do hope that you liked this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't like the video, please feel free to thumbs the video down. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new here, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.